Hey fellas, welcome back for another exciting episode here at Prime Auto Works headquarters. In this exciting episode, I get some paint on it. Now, I don't go real in-depth on the overall paint work, but I do spend a lot of time showing you how I paint the engine nozzles, because I know that's always somewhat of a pain, but I really like how these turned out. And it's really simple to do. So I show you how I do that. I forgot what else. I don't think I showed much else, maybe. I don't know. I forget. Because I filmed this over like a span of a week and I just kind of throw stuff together. But here's what we got going on. As you can see, I went with the VF92 color scheme. And right now I'm working on the decals. I'm using Aero Design decals, which are really good. But I'm still having a few little issues getting them settled down onto panel lines just because I'm not good at decals. I mean, I don't like it. I don't know. But anyway, I'm working on those, and I think I'll probably include some decal work in my next video, how I'm trying to get these to settle down with a little bit of Solvacet and some other tricks that I'm using to get those to settle down. So, but that's not the subject of this video. So let's go ahead and get on with the video. All right, fellas. So I am ready to start the paint work. And I've decided to go ahead and do this one just because I think it's more pleasing to the eye. I don't like this decal right here. I think that looks goofy, the chest piece. But I like the color palette on this one a little bit better than this one. So that's the one I'm going to do. This is going to be a little bit more difficult because I do have to mix paint. Now, I have paint left over from the last one that I did that I matched with the decal. It's a yellow and a little bit of red just to darken it up a bit. And it does match the decal that I'm going to use for this piece right here. I've also got some radome tan mixed up. I may lighten this a little bit, but this is what I typically use for the radomes. I may put a little bit more, maybe yellow and white in this. I'm not sure. I'll spray that and figure that out. But what I decided to do for this one, now typically I do black basing, and I want the colors on this one to be a little bit more vibrant. Now this is, I think, light gold gray, I believe, and then like an off-white on the bottom. Now for the bottom, I'm just going to use regular white because I want it to, like I said, want it to be a little bit more vibrant. So in order to do that and to make all these colors pop a little bit more than black basing, I've decided to go ahead and prime it with Mr. Finishing Surfacer Gray, which is, these Mr. Finishing Surfacer products are the best primer in my opinion to use. I went ahead and wet sanded it, and then I came along and I did some pre-shading with some black. I didn't spray it on too heavy, as you can see, with the black. And then I took some white and I did some marbling over the gray. And right there. So I've got that going. Now, I'll show you how I do my marbling layer. What I do is I just take regular Tamiya X2 white, XF2, and I thin it down to about 70-30 mixture. 70% paint, or 70% thinner to 30% paint. Now, white, this Tamiya white seems to clog up a lot and tip dry. So how to avoid that is when you're spraying, you want to spray and then push it all the way forward so you're just blowing air, and that's going to keep that Tamiya paint from sticking to the needle. If I would just do this and then let go, what's going to happen is that paint's going to stick on that needle and then you're going to start getting splatters. So make sure you're shooting out air when you stop and keep shooting it out, and that will help alleviate that issue. Okay, so for the marbling layer, all I'm doing is I'm just coming in here. And sometimes it gets kind of clogged up. Not really clogged up, but it takes a while for it to shoot out. So what I do is I just pull it back, shoot a bunch of paint out, and then I should be able to start shooting out paint, okay? So all I'm doing with this marbling layer is just coming in here. And this is going to give a little bit more depth to my paintwork. Now, I can go heavier in some areas where I might want it to look a little more faded than others. But the main purpose of why I'm doing this is just to vary up when I put my light gold gray down and my over colors, just to make it look not so uniform. See, I'm getting a little bit of splattering there. I can also take a Q-tip, and I'll put a little bit of thinner on here. Okay. And you want to be careful when you do this so you don't hurt the needle. But all I'm doing is I'm taking that Q-tip and I'm just slowly going around. I'm not pressing hard because I don't want to bend the tip of that needle. I'm just going to clean that off. Okay. And I'll shoot some paint. Still pushing air out, but no paint. And I should be good to go. And my paint's been in here a while, so starts to do funny things when your paint's been in the color couple, especially this white paint's been in here a while. It'll start to do funny stuff. Now when I go to paint that yellow along the top here, this is going to be a bit of a pain to mask off right up here, but I think it'll be worth it once I'm done. So that's how I do my marbling layer right there, fellas. All right, fellas. So I'm in the process of masking, and there's a lot of masking to do on this build. I went ahead and I sprayed the nose, and I've got that masked off. I sprayed all the white, and I've masked off the white areas that I have here. Next, I want to spray the light gold gray. Now, as you can see here, there's a demarcation between the white and the light gold gray. And what I've seen is it's somewhat of a soft edge on the real thing. Now, I can recreate that one of several ways. Now, I could try to do it by hand, but to be honest with you, it's going to be a little bit softer by hand with my skill level than what I'd like. I could also make a little worm out of this sticky putty stuff that you get. You can make little worms and do it that way. But what I've found works really well is I've got this Tamiya tape for curves. And the reason I'm using this is because it's somewhat thick. Let me set this back a little bit. And I'm going to actually increase the thickness a little bit by layering it. Okay, so I'm just going to lay this down. I might be able to get away with just using this if I sprayed at the right angle, but I'm just going to go ahead and put two layers of this together, and I'll show you how I do this. Now, last time I did this, I think it really turned out the way I wanted. So I'm just going to lay this on top of this other one here. Just like so. So I got a nice thick piece. I'm going to come with my X-Acto blade. You can see that it's not just a straight line. There's a little bit of a waviness to it. So I'm going to go ahead and cut that waviness into my piece, right down the center. Just like so. Okay. All right. This piece should be long enough. I'll go ahead and take one of these. I've got my little mask that I've created here. I'm going to go ahead and place it where I think it should go. Take a toothpick. Probably don't need to go that far, but I did. Okay. And you can see that's going to give me a nice smooth transition between the light gold gray and the white. Now then I'll come along and I'll put another piece of tape down here to mask this area off so I don't get light gold gray on the white. And I'll do the same thing along the back here and right along here and on the other side. So this is a method that I like to use for getting those nice soft demarcation lines. All right, fellas, as you can see here, we're gonna paint some exhaust nozzles. Now I've already got a good start. A while back when I did the rest of the exhaust, I got the insides painted, as you can see there. I always like to paint the insides first and then paint the outside. I just find it to be easier. On the outside, what I did is I sprayed down a coat of Mr. Color GX2, which is a gloss black lacquer. You don't necessarily need a gloss coat for this, but I would recommend a primer coat because I am going to do some masking. I've got AK Extreme Metal Aluminum over top of that to give me the aluminum part. And the reason that I say you probably need a primer is because metallic paint does not stick well to bare plastic. And I am gonna be doing some masking, so I want to make sure that it sticks to my part. Now, I've got a picture here that I pulled off the interwebs that I like the look of. I mean, there's a couple different ways you could paint it, probably a number of different ways you could paint it. And I don't think either it'd be right or wrong, but I just like the look of this. So how I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna use some Tamiya clear colors. I've got smoke, clear blue, and clear orange. And I like to thin these with isopropyl alcohol, especially when I do this. That way I can layer and it dries really quick and I can throw a bunch of layers on at a time and not have to worry about it spider webbing as much. If I use Mr. Color leveling thinner and I try to get in there and spray thin layers really quick, it's going to spider web and just do all kinds of nasty stuff that I don't want. But if I use isopropyl alcohol, it dries super quick. This is 91% if I didn't say that. So anyway, I'm going to get some of this, I'm going to get my brush, my airbrush. Again, I don't have a stand. I break something, fellas. I'm going to start off with some clear smoke. Let's see. Okay, so I'm just gonna take some IPA, shove it in there, and then I'm gonna take some of my smoke, put it in there. Okay, so I've got about a 70-30 mix, 70% isopropyl alcohol, 30% mix of paint is what I'm going for. Now, there we go. Now, if this jar kind of glued together with the paint makes these lids stick sometimes. One way to open, if you get a Tamiya jar that you can't open because it's stuck, good way to get the jar unstuck is to take a hot blow dryer and put it on high heat and then blow around it for about 30 seconds, heat it up, and that softens that paint, and then you can open it. So I'm gonna add just a little bit of orange in here just to give it this more of a brown look to it. So now I'm down to a little more paint in my ratio, which is fine. Probably be at maybe 50%, 60-40, something like that. Okay. It's a great video, huh, guys? Watch me, like, close paint jars. I need to get a stand over here. Okay, so let's blow some of this out, see what we got going on. So there's kind of the color we're gonna use. Kind of a brownish, a dark brown. So I'm gonna come along here, and I'm just gonna layer this. And this is one of those things you can't really be in a rush in, because if I try to spray too much, even with the IPA, it's going to spider web on you. But by the time I kind of go all the way around the world here, it'll have dried on the other side. Now, some of these darker spots, I'm going to add a little bit of blue to this here in a minute, but some of the darker spots, and if I put like a wash on here, it's going to bring out some of the, it's going to highlight some of these details, these raised details and crevices and stuff. So we are going to add a wash to this, and I may actually add a magic wash. I don't know. Let's see. I think I'll probably add a magic wash, to be honest with you. And this doesn't have to be even. So I can add a little bit more here and a little bit more there. Doesn't necessarily have to match. And then once I add keep in mind when I add a magic wash or a oil wash, it's going to darken this up too. So keep that in mind as well. All right. So I'm going to get on with coating this one, and then I'll catch you on the next step. Okay, so now I've got my orangish brown put down. I'm going to add a little bit of blue, and then I'm going to mask off that area. So I'm going to got my color cup cleaned out, and I'm going to mix the blue just a little thicker than I did the other stuff. Oh, I'm almost out of blue. Okay. All right. Alright, that's pretty thick. Okay, now I'm just going to go in a few little areas up here, and I'm just going to hit some areas with some blue. Just to change things up a bit and add a little bit of color in here. Mix it up. All right, yeah, this is really thick. All right, just like so. This little hint of stuff. Just a little hint of blue. Okay, now what I'm going to do
is I'm going to mask off
some masking tape out here. I'm putting the tape on my forehead, my greasy forehead, to kind of take some of the tackiness down. I'm going to mask off this area right here. And I'm really not letting this dry a whole, I mean, completely, like, cure. And I'm not real concerned if the tape lifts some stuff off. I don't think it will, but if it does, it's okay. It's just going to add to the look of it. Let's call it weathering if it lifts some tape or some of this coloring off. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my blue. And I'm going to tint this band along the bottom. Now, it's easy to go overboard. So, it's, you know, when you start spraying, you don't see a whole lot. And then, all of a sudden, it's like, oh my God, this is like super blue. So, I think that'll work. I'll do the same thing to the other one, and then we'll be back here for the next step. All right, now that we got our blue down, now I'm going to, I still got it masked off, and I'm going to take some NATO black, and I'm going to, again, mix this with isopropyl alcohol. Not sure how much I got in there. I probably won't need much. Eh, a little bit more. Okay. Just take a little bit of NATO black. I'm going to come along and I'm just going to start spraying NATO black in kind of a haphazardy fashion, kind of like a marbling layer. I could probably come in with another lighter gray and do the same thing. In fact, I may do that. All right, fellas. So what I've done is I've added a little bit of white, actually a lot of white, to the NATO black. And I'm going to come in here and I'm going to vary up some of the coloring. Again, I don't really want to get into a pattern. I just almost want to do this randomly. Like so. Vary up. Get that. So vary it up. Kind of what it looks like. All right, fellas, now that I've got this where I want them, I'm going to put a magic wash on them. And I think I showed this in the, I know I showed this recently, but I'm going to use Pledge Floor Care, which is a lot of people, otherwise known as Future. A lot of people use it as a clear coat. I do too, because it's cheap. I've had that bottle forever. There are so many haters on Future. A lot of people like, oh, don't use Future. That's just so stupid. Like, I don't know. Works for me. Anyway, I'm going to take some of my Vallejo Black acrylic paint. And because this This floor care is an acrylic clear coat. They mix. So I'm mixing it together. Maybe a little bit more. I do want this somewhat dark. Just gonna brush this on. And let this kind of do what it wants. Now this does have a tendency to like, if you get too much on here, it'll settle, and then you'll have like a real dark spot at the bottom. So I want to kind of brush some of this off, and I may put this on in layers. This also dries really fast. I'm going to hit this with a hairdryer and I'll be right back. All right, now I've hit this with a hairdryer and I'm wanting to darken up these turkey feathers, I think is what they're called. So I just got a little bit darker mixture and I'm darkening these up to where I want them. That'll look good. I may get them too dark, who knows? All right. I think I will be happy with that. And then what I can do to finish it off, I'll put a flat coat on it, and then I'll come along and with my airbrush, I'm just gonna hit the ends of these to give them that little burnt look that you see on the ends, just barely, with some straight black. So that's all there is to it, fellas, I think. All right, fellas, I'm getting ready to put a clear coat on this, but I wanted to kind of piece it together so we can get a good idea what we're looking at here. I may actually mark off some panels and paint them a little bit different shade before I put a clear coat on it. I haven't quite decided if I want to do that yet or not. The walkways, the decal set that I have actually gives you decals for the walkways, but I decided to go ahead and paint those on. I almost think they should be a little bit darker, but you know, I'm not gonna remask them. I'll definitely do some oil work on these once I get the decals down and get a flat coat on it. The front here, this was a little bit of a pain to mask, this little scoop. I did mask it and paint it, but then I had to come back and touch it up with a brush. The black little thing here, I don't know if it's an antenna or what, I ended up painting that with a brush rather than masking that, as well as the tail fin was a real beast. Now, I did mask and paint the top here with that yellow color. It was took me a while to do that, and then I just came back and hand brushed the black. The exhaust nozzles, I think, turned out really well. Now, I did actually end up, once I put a flat coat on them, I took some Vallejo Silver and I just dry brushed them because they were a little too dark. So that lightened them up a little bit and then highlighted some of that raised detail, which I think looks pretty good. So I'm happy with the exhaust nozzles. Underneath the tail here, I used some Tamiya clear colors, that orange and smoke mixture, and I stained the bottom. And then I ended up taking some strips of tape and making these little ridges, and then sprayed some black and some NATO black down for some like exhaust staining there. And then that's pretty much it. Now for the metallic areas, what I do here, and I didn't show it, but I think I've shown it before, is I'll spray my base aluminum color down, and then I'll take a darker color like a dark aluminum or a gunmetal, and I'll just spray inside of, in the center. And it's not really in your face, but when the light hits it, it just gives the metallic area a little bit more depth. So that's about it. I'm gonna go ahead and put a clear coat on this and then throw down some decals and then go from there. So I'll throw up some pictures. Thanks for watching, fellas. I'll catch you on the next video.